Firstly, I'd like to give you, well, I'd like to thank you for coming out tonight too, but firstly, I'd like to give you some advice. Never write a musical. Unless you are a type of person who enjoys stress weighing down on you for years at a time. This all began, I never intended to write a musical in the first place. I wrote a song called Don't Fear Me, which was this messy, chaotic song that I sang over here at the Grand when TML were over there, and I think it was at an open mic or something like that. And in the introduction to the song, I said, I need a serial killer state of mind to sing this song right. And that song then just somehow gained the name of the serial killer song. A little while later, Colin Trigwell, who isn't here tonight, unfortunately, said, after hearing the song, that reminds me of a song from a rock opera. And I just went, oh, yeah. But then it kind of like, boom, rock opera. Oh, I love rock operas. Wonder if I could write a rock opera. And anyway, well, I've got serial killer, rock opera, about a serial killer. And I just went home and started writing a song, which is the first song you'll hear little Emily sing, which is actually the first song written for the musical. The serial killer song wasn't, it was a song on its own. And so I was looking to write a rock opera, and as I got about 8 songs into it, I began to realise that the story was getting too complicated to do everything in song. I thought, oh, this is going to turn out to have like 110 songs if I try and connect all these bits with songs. So I got lazy, and I started connecting things with dialogue just to make it easier. And so I've completely forgotten what I was going to say now. How about we just get on with the music? Please welcome to the stage the most wonderful group of people I have ever known in my entire life, the Fretters. Nicholas Watting, Ben Wilson, Tim Barella, Geraldine Barella, that old woman, no, Christina, Melbourne, of course it is, Neville Condon, Emily Thompson, Matt Colley, and Danielle Linda, and over the back there, on the keyboards, Peter Lawler. Let's get started. Our tale begins in an unnamed town, in an unnamed state, in an unnamed country. A strange little boy, 9-year-old Daniel Adams, stands silently at the foot of his parents' bed. He's watching them sleep. He likes to watch them sleep. They sleep deep, still. He wonders what it would be like if they never woke up. But they do. Daniel's parents knows that their child is very strange, very, very strange indeed. They wonder if the reason for this could be because they dropped him on his head when he was a baby, or encouraged the family dog to eat him, or perhaps because they drugged him every single night, or maybe they shouldn't have told him that they hated him and wanted him dead instead of, we love you, Daniel. Or perhaps the reason is they shouldn't have smoked around the baby. Thank you.
dedication. Nate's bucking around with again.
They're kind of crap.